Hello there, ladies, gents, everything between and without. Welcome back to more Sam and Max at the Road. What will be the last part of Sam and Max at the Road? Because, well, I've just decided to finish it now. Let's first talk to this chap before we do anything else.
Can you spare a second?
Not really. But since you're saving my species from extinction, what the heck?
What do you make of the first totem pole?
As you know, this is a problem that I've been working on for many years. Research strongly suggests this totem pole to be representative of the whirlwind nature of us Bigfoots. Wild and always moving.
Okay.
What's your take on the second totem pole?
I'm glad you asked. You see, I believe that it represents the sharp edge of ancient history. The fantastic staying power of the Yeti people over the millennia.
How does the third pole figure into the scheme of things?
Let me be very clear. That pole constitutes the harmony from the coexistence of two similar beings. The harmony that springs from mutual respect and understanding.
What does the fourth totem pole represent?
I'm asked that very question all the time. My answer, rapid growth.
Okay.
What can you tell us about Bruno?
Is it me, or does it feel as if we've asked just about everybody in the country about Bruno?
Yep.
Ah, Bruno. Full of vim and vigor, ready to take on the world. He reminds me of when I was his age.
1,000 years ago?
What do you think about Trixie?
She's such a sweet girl. And very representative of the open-mindedness of our Yeti leadership. We're very proud of that.
Wait, she's not a Yeti, what?
What's your official stance on Conroy Bumpus?
Conroy Bumpus is a threat to the American way of life. It has been and continues to be of highest importance that we rid ourselves of this most negative influence on the young people of our brave new world. The missus and I sure like his music, though.
Confusing.
You know, I'm really anxious about this whole totem pole thing.
It'll work. Trust me.
I met Anxious once. He's the one with the drool in his beard.
That wasn't Anxious. It was your cotton candy.
Well, that certainly clears up one mystery.
He was referencing Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, by the way, you know? Each one representing a state of being. Apparently there was no Anxious one.
I'm still having nightmares about alligators.
I know that everyone involved with this extraordinary quest has had their demons to contend with. But let me make one thing perfectly clear. It'll be worth it.
Ack! He said quest! I think my furry little body may break out in a rash of unsightly hives.
We'll be back.
I'll be here.
Okay, let's first use the tooth. This is ancient history.
Hey, Chiefy Poo. I think I figured out one of those baffling totem poles.
A genuine dinosaur tooth. I figured it might be something like that.
Did he say genuine?
Yeah, it's not genuine. Sorry to disappoint you, mate. It's not. Next up, the hair thing. Rapid growth. Hair gel. Or
hey,
growth formula.
Hey, Mr. Chief. We found something that might tie into your totem poles.
Yeah? What is it?
And
hair growth tonic. Very resourceful.
We just like stealing pillows.
Me too, mate. Me too. Next up we have the vegetable head. Combination of humanity and nature. In the form of vegetables.
I believe we've deduced the secret of one of your totem poles.
Hit me. The combination of man and nature. Inventive.
Is it soup yet?
Nope. Well, let's leave. I said leave. We have one more thing to do. The swirl. And if you haven't figured it out yet, the swirl is, of course, the mystery vortex.
I don't think the ice pick will remove the cork. I don't think the ice pick will remove the cork.
Do it anyway, goddammit.
I don't think the ice pick will remove the cork.
And what will remove the cork, you idiot?
I can't use these things. I can't use these things.
Why can't you?
I can't use.
Lord,
I'm tired of this drivel.
Whoopsies. Mistake there. Okay.
I don't think the ice pick will remove the cork.
Yeah, it will.
I don't think the ice pick will remove the cork.
It will break the bottle. Shut up.
I can't use these things to. I can't use the.
Really, dude?
I can't use these. I can't.
Then what can you use together?
I can't use. I can't use these. I can't use these. I can't.
Whoopsies. Mistake.
I can't use these. I can't use these. I can't use. I don't think the ice pick will remove the cork.
Oh, for
Lord,
fuck's
I'm
sake.
Tired of this drivel. I can't use these. I don't think the ice.
God damn it.
I'm tired of this drivel. I can't use these.
Damn it.
I can't use these things.
I'm getting fucking desperate here, people. What the hell? Okay. Let me think about for a second. Okay. well. Let's go. This sounds really stupid. We need to go back to the biggest ball of twine. Yep, that shitty place again. Why, you ask? Well, you'll see in a jiffy. Get out! Damn it, Sam. Why do you suck so much? Use, go, do, etc. So the whole idea is to use the tool bender to bend your ice pick into something which resembles a wine.
Shake a leg, Max.
A wine bottle opener. A bottle opener, basically, you know? But that's stupid, because I think you can open bottles with ice picks or even knives, you know? You just put them in and you twist. In a certain way, of course. Dude?
Could you bend this? Sure. Let's see it.
Alakazam. Alakazui. Alakazam. Alakazui. Alakazam.
Great.
Great, now we have one of these things. Exciting.
That seems to have gotten the cork off.
Shall we raise a toast to nuclear disarmament?
With this poison? Don't be silly.
Okay, we take this, use it on
that
this.
That seems to have capped the snow globe.
And now we shall use it to get the mystery vortex.
I've got to use this elevator.
Oh, shut up, Sam. Now, we get the swirling nature of the Bigfoot by stealing the mystery vortex and probably depriving the local area of some of its income, you know, from tourism. AKA Sam and Max, the disruptors of local businesses. They're kind of dicks like that, we must say. Well, what was I saying? Where do I want to go? Oh yeah, the mystery vortex, correct. So we're back here, eh? The spooky music and the like. Sorry, ma'am, but you're going to have to find a new job soon.
Can we try the vortex?
Step right in.
Okay then. Snow globe. And use. It's bye-bye, Mystery
wow,
Vortex.
The snow globe actually sucked in the pseudo-mystical energies of the Mystery Vortex.
I was hoping something like that would happen.
Okay, then let's get the fuck out of here already. And finish the game. Out, I said out. There we go. Alright, final thoughts. Before we even end. Brilliant game, brilliant puzzles, you know, some of them pretty hard to figure out. I actually saw some Let's Plays of this game, you know, a long time ago and sort of remember some of them. For example, the Mystery Vortex deal I remember from that. But it's pretty smartly constructed, what can I say? Go, damn it, go. There we are. Now go there. Sam is fat, so Sam kind of waddles around. Go there, damn it. There! What the f- Seriously, what the hell are you doing, Sam? There we are. Go, go, go. Yo, guy, we got your final item. Now I can make your magic happen.
I think I figured out one of the totem poles. Let me see.
Handheld vortex. Good thinking.
Thinking had nothing to do with it.
Well, that should do it, right?
Nothing's happening, Sam.
What's the story, Pops?
I don't know. I'm sure you got the ingredients right, but... Of course. How silly of me.
What?
In order for the spell to work, we need a living Bigfoot sacrifice.
It'd be a shame to lose one of these furry fellas, don't you think?
Wait, I've got an idea, and it doesn't require high explosives. Wait here.
While he's gone, I'll go see if any of the Bigfoots wants to off themselves for the greater good.
Ah, Max is up to some bullshit. There we are. Bye-bye, Conroy. Your legend will go on forever. Ooh, big sight of the rain. Oh my god, trees in San Francisco. No. From coast to coast, the forest.
Well, that was
spring.
One heck of an impressive display,
and actually highly destructive to boot.
Goodbye, Sam and Max. I'm not sure how I could ever thank you, so I guess I won't.
What an asshole!
Will you and Trixie be heading back into the forest to live an idyllic, nature-oriented existence together?
Hell no! We're going to Vegas to get hitched. If it hasn't been trashed by all this crazy redwood nonsense.
We want to be in a place where we can sort of blend in. Live our lives, maybe even raise a family.
Ew.
Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye, you nutsy primitive man beast, you.
You boys should be proud of what you've helped us achieve here today.
What?
You mean
destruction
the wholesale
of America?
Destruction of the symbols of modern civilization in the Western United States? You bet we are.
Do we win a prize?
Well, oh, why not? This medallion has been a part of my family for untold generations. Wear it in good health.
Wow, gold.
Thanks, Chief. Max loves cheap sentiment.
Oh, wow, it's chocolate.
Mmm, foil-covered chocolatey goodness. What's wrong, Sam?
I don't think the wizard has anything in that bag for me.
Well, I could give you my ritual headdress that I bought at Snucky's last week.
I appreciate the gesture, but I've already got a hat.
Well, that's fine, too. Farewell, Sam and Max. Remember, though the night be dark, the dawn yet shall awaken and annoy you. Have a nice day.
Okay.
I'll miss that old rascal.
I'll miss the way he smelled like a bag full of damp hamster shavings. Just like Grandpa. Hey, we forgot to get paid.
Don't worry, little buddy. I've got it all covered.
I hope you're happy. With those idiots on the case, we'll probably never see Bruno again.
Oh, lighten up, Burl. Hey, they're back.
Did you find Bruno?
Of course.
Bruno!
How can we ever repay you?
The blank looks on your faces are the only reward we need.
That and a big fat check.
Would you settle for 3,000 skee-ball tickets?
Close enough. Let's go, Max. You know, Max, I can't help thinking that we've foolishly tampered with the fragile inner mechanisms of this little spaceship we call Earth.
Gosh, Sam, if a few hundred years of civilization have to be totaled just to ensure that a bunch of smelly quasi-human creatures have a safe haven for their disgusting lifestyles, then so be it!
You crack me up, little buddy.
Yeah, you do.
Burl, did Bruno always have four arms?
Of course. Wait, can we... Oh, wow! An interactive credit sequence. Can we shoot Max? Oh, cool. If this passes the middle of the screen... Wait. If it is in the middle of the screen... Shoot it, Max. Shoot it. Okay. Final thoughts on Sam and Max of the Road. Awesome game, awesome. The graphics are a bit dated, but no, it's cartoony, it's fun. Oh wow, it's R2-D2. Shit him. What can I say? I love it. I will be doing the whole Sam and Max series, so stay tuned for that. The sounds were, you know, nice and cartoony. The jokes were funny, the references also, the puzzles were smart. These are the kind of puzzles we need nowadays. Wow, that's a tentacle from Day of the Tentacle, another LucasArts game. Which I don't know if we will be playing anytime soon, maybe somewhere in the future, who knows. So yeah, This game is great, highly recommended. It's on goodoldgames.com if you want it legally. I guess that's kind of it. What can I say? I will still. The other 7 Max games are quite a few. After this, they tried to make a game, 7 Max Freelance Police. Unfortunately, they failed. I think all that we got was a trailer out of it, unfortunately. But then Telltale got it, and that's kind of how they started up making 7, well, kind of. I think those were their first successes. So they made the 7 Max Season 1, which is 6 games, 6 short games, about an hour or two at the most each. Then they made Season 2 with 5, and then Season 3 with 5, aka the Devil's Playhouse. We will get to them in due course. Actually, I think I will start the next one on Wednesday. Tomorrow will again be a World of Warcraft day. And I guess you can stop now. I don't want to. It's fun. Not really. Also the jokes. Let's see what they say. It's over. No, it's not. It'll never be over. 7 Max will never be over. We're leaving. Okay, bye-bye. I'm staying. Ah, fucking idiots. Okay, well guys, I guess that's... Oh. Okay, so cut. Anything else you want to tell us? By the way, I'm kind of pissed off that they didn't use their guns once in this game. Once! That's kind of disappointing, but we will make up for it in the next games where they will use their guns aplenty. So I guess that's it guys, I hope you've enjoyed this LP, see you on the next one, bye bye!